The argument over the future of cars is getting electric.
Well, I can tell you how much electric car costs more than on, the same standard. It's $28,000.
Well, that's great. We've got a Prime Minister spending his time in the motor pages. That's super.
Both say they want to see more electric vehicles on Australia's roads. Labor's aiming for 50% of new cars to be electric by 2030. The Liberals want between a quarter and 50% of all new vehicles to be EV by 2025. Dr. Keenan Degamenci has researched renewable energies for many years and says we need to reduce carbon emissions much faster.
Australia has made the commitment for the Paris Agreement, so we have to reduce carbon emissions by promoting electric vehicles, but also, most importantly, promoting renewable energy sources.
When it comes to electric cars, motorists still have questions. Why are they so expensive? Will they emit less carbon? And what about the cost of replacing more expensive electric batteries? Range is important in terms of battery storage, and so is loading infrastructure, says Dr. Keenan. Currently, the electric vehicle fleet in Australia represents 0.2% of total cars.
We need more share of renewable energy sources in Australia.
Currently, electric vehicles can travel above 250 kilometres on a single charge. The Tesla Model X can reach up to 500 kilometres on a single charge with towing capacity. A national rollout of ultra-rapid charging is proposed as an investment priority over the next 15 years. That could mean it will just take a few minutes to power up your green car.
And our study found that the environmental performance is even more important for potential consumers than price and range, because it is a critical distinction that you're making here compared to the combustion engine.
Norway already has more electric vehicles per capita than any other country, and they've achieved their CO2 emission targets 3 years earlier than pledged. If Australia is to meet its commitment to lower emissions, electric cars could soon be a far more common sight here. Chris Smith, QUT News.